Hi, my name is Riata Scott and I'm back for another quick HTML and CSS lesson. In a previous video, we looked at the CSS pseudo-class that allowed us to change the text color of different link states. In this video, we'll use a pseudo-class again, this time to change the background color of every other row in a table because it just simply makes it easier to read the table. Now, you could do this by creating a class with a background color property and adding it to every other row manually, but then if you ever need to insert or delete a row anywhere in the middle of the table, you'd have to update the class on each row that came after the one you inserted or deleted. With the technique we'll use today, the background color application will be automated, so you can insert and delete as much as you want without a problem. If you want to learn more about pseudo-classes, you should check out w3schools.com and search for pseudo-classes. But for now, let's just get started. I'm using an embedded style sheet for the table rather than putting these styles in the external style sheet because maybe I don't want these same styles on all tables on my website. Just remember that the browser will display the styles that are closest to the content, so we want to be sure to put the embedded style under the link for the external style sheet, like we've done here. I've already added some basic styling to the table. You can see that over here. So now we'll do the alternating rows part. As many of you know, T-head, T-body, and T-foot are not required tags for a table, but they do provide us with more tag selectors to use when styling. In this case, we're going to use the T-body tag for creating alternate rows. So let's add the following. I'm just going to put it right under table. Order doesn't really matter. And I'm going to add T-body space, TR colon, and then our pseudo class, nth child, and then we specify what nth child. In this case, it's odd. Put our curly bracket, close it. So what we're saying here is that this applies to rows inside of the t-body that are the nth child, and that nth child is odd-numbered rows. So the first, third, and fifth row, etc., will get whatever properties we add next. If you typed even instead of odd, it would be the second, fourth, sixth, and so on rows. All right, so let's add background hyphen color colon. Let's make that orange, semicolon. Then our next one will be color colon white semicolon, and that's going to make our text white on the orange background. And then let's just make it bold so it's easy to read. So font hyphen weight colon bold semicolon. Let's save this and take a look at it in the browser. So here's what it looked like before, and here it is with the pseudo class. Looks good. Let's try one more thing before we go. What if we want three different colors in the rows? So every third row be something. We have, like, let's say white and then whatever the background color already is and then orange. Let's do this. We'll change odd here to 3n. That's going to mean every third row. And we'll just leave that orange, white, and bold. So that would be row 3, 6, 9, etc. All right. Then I'm going to copy that. And I'll paste it. And then instead of 3n, we're going to have 3n plus 1. So that means every third row plus 1 before it starts. And our background color, I'm just going to make that white. And the color of our text, I'll make black. And while I'm at it, I'm trying to find where I had all of these others, table TD. Let's go ahead and make everything bold. I could have just put font weight there. Font weight, bold. Semicolon. So I will save that. OK, Control S, and we'll take a look at that in the browser. And now we've got white, and this one has no background color, so it's picking up that background color, and then orange, and then white, no color, orange, white, no color, orange. So that's how you do that. Next time we revisit styling tables, we'll add rounded corners. So be sure to subscribe to our channel so you'll know when we add new things. Thank you for watching this video. Students, faculty, and staff of the University of Missouri-Columbia can register for free classes by logging into training.missouri.edu.